Alamance County is pleased to present the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.
The Alamance County Board of Commissioners is now in session. Thank all of you for coming this evening. We have a large crowd, so if we can be orderly and quiet so we can hear what everybody has to say, hopefully. We have a lot of people signed up for the public comments, and the public comment policy of the Alamance County Board of Commissioners is on the in the same book that you signed up in. I hope that everybody read the policy. There is one paragraph I would like to specifically read. That's paragraph 2. Each person desiring to speak during the public comment period shall have 3 minutes to make his or her remarks. There shall be no more than 3 speakers on any one topic per meeting. Sorry. You want me to read it again?
The mic's not on.
The mic? Is it on now?
Yeah, we can barely hear the prayer.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. Now, let me read it again. As I said, this board has passed some time ago the policy for public comments, and there is a copy of that policy on the notebook where you signed up to speak. I know many people we had, most of you did not have time to read that policy, but again, I want to read one particular paragraph. That's paragraph number 2. Each person desiring to speak during the public comment period shall have 3 minutes to make his or her remarks. There shall be no more than 3 speakers on any one topic per meeting. So we've got 3 or 4 pages of people who did sign up, and let me assure you, this board wants to hear what you have to say. Now, the chair may not be the brightest star in the galaxy, and I certainly admit to that, but
is it going off again?
But the other commissioners are real, very intelligent, and what I'm driving at is repetition does not make anything easier for us to understand. We pick up on it pretty good. All right, we have...
Mr. Chair, how many people do you have signed up?
We have about 30. I can't read most of them. Yeah, here we go. Yeah, we have a 29.
When we had our budget vote, where was that? I don't even know where it was held at.
I'm in the library.
No, I'm talking about the fiscal
vote.
Was that Williams High School or?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
If I'm not mistaken, I mean, we didn't hear to that policy that night.
That's a public hearing. This is the...
Just speaker comments.
Yeah, this is the comment policy, not the public hearing.
It's always been there, Tim.
No, it hasn't.
Well, it's been there since I've been here.
Yeah, it was there when we instituted, and, you know, I want to hear what the citizens have to say. And, you know, I would like to see us... I'm not doing it for that reason. You know, I appreciate any... I want to hear what the citizens have to say. And I make a motion that we waive the rules for tonight. And I think we should have that prerogative on any meeting.
Oh, I think you do.
Amen. I second the motion.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Passes. First one is, and if I can't read your name, I'm sorry, but Mike Holland. Is he in there?
Yeah.
To save time, let's line people up so we don't have to wait for all of them to come in. The next one is Elizabeth Rains.
I'm here, sir. I'm here.
I got you. Just hold on. Doug Williams, Mike Curry, Laurel Oxley, looks like Mike Howard, and Judy Ward. Y'all would all come and get in line. Mr. Holland, go right ahead. 3 minutes.
County Commissioners, Chair, thank you so much. This is a public statement from the community of Saxmahaw from a public forum this weekend. I'd like to present it to y'all. And we have some folks that would be speaking, and they would be submitting theirs as well to go in this.
Absolutely. Thank you.
When we found out January 16th about this facility, we had to ask the question, why Saxmahaw? The stated case was that it was going to be a facility that was large, this was in the paper, that made money. It was a regional draw for training for fire and rescue people from around the area. And so to us, we thought we're far from the interstate, and we have no water. We have farmland, we have farmers, hardworking dairy farmers. So why Saxmahaw? We looked at another alternative position. This is Swepsonville's old landfill site, which has a 1 mile road network, has a quarter mile of paved roads, has a security fence, a 500 foot antenna. It's got 346 acres over three parcels that are all joined. This looked like a phenomenal location. Across the street from the entrance here is an 8-inch water pipe that the mayor of Swepsonville says will supply water very nicely, and Newton's Fire and Rescue is in Swepsonville. We had to ask ourselves, why Saxmahaw? So we looked back. In 1996, we put in an application to the Clean Water Management Trust Fund for a state park grant for $4 million. It didn't go through. The Hot River State Park ended up river. In 2004, you were sitting right here as the county attorney then. We spent a lot of time together. And after 2 months, we took two votes, one to privatize the landfill and sell it to a company in Raleigh for $40 million, and another vote to extend the landfill service area to 60 counties. And in 2 months, the citizens of Saxmahaw showed this commission that the staff's idea was a bad idea. And we convinced y'all to unvote those two votes. You rescinded those votes. This commission made the political brave statement right before the election to do that. We were so glad for that. We come up in 2008, land was bought across from the landfill for an expansion, for a buffer. And in this year, luckily and happily, you were elected commissioner, and in December announced county commissioner chair, and then in January we hear that you are behind this, you are for this move to Saxmahaw. And we looked at the landfill then, because we had worked on the landfill together trying to preserve that for the county, for the county's use back in 2004. And we looked at the land beside the landfill, the 1,100 acre parcel that Bruce Cameron owned. And he died in April, and we had to say to ourselves, this gentleman died in April. He was a wonderful old man. We really respect him. His grandchildren now have the property. What would happen if you put a facility of this nature, a high-impact use facility, across from the landfill entrance, so that that road now, which has effectively kept development off that 1,100 acres for 20 years, because nobody wants to drive past the landfill into a dead-end dirt road, and it's locked by the Orange County border and the Haw River. How much time do I have left?
I see it.
Okay. Thank you so much for considering finding the best location possible for our good sheriff. We want it. Everybody I've talked to does. And we want to support that best location, but we don't think that's Saxmahaw. We don't want a 1,500-acre mega landfill. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, Doug. Elizabeth Rains.
I'll be speaking on behalf of Elizabeth Rains.
This is Elizabeth Rains.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Are you Elizabeth Rains?
I am. Hello, my name is Elizabeth Rains, and I am from Saxmahaw. I was from Saxmahaw before anyone thought that Saxmahaw could ever be considered cool. I went to BEJ, B. Everett Jordan, and Southern Alamance Middle and High Schools. I grew up, I went away to college, and I came home. I say home because Saxmahaw has always been and always will be my home. I was so certain of this that 10 years ago, I spent my life savings and inheritance buying my family home place and property here. That property is less than 500 yards from the proposed training center site on Austin Quarter Road. Now, I haven't heard anyone suggest that Alamance County Fire and Police officers are not currently adequately trained, nor have I heard that evidence heard any evidence suggesting that this training center would improve the training that our county emergency response teams and law enforcement officers receive. However, if the existing Alamance County facilities do not offer adequate training, and the numerous facilities in the surrounding counties do not satisfy our training needs, then I definitely support adding to our existing facilities or building another facility to provide the training. That being said, I can't imagine that Saxbahaw could be the best location for a training center. We are a quiet little community of people who live out there because it is quiet. I could talk about the dairy farms that would fail, or the well water, or the inconvenience to the interstate, or the food and lodging that's not there. I could go on and on about logistic concerns that seem incongruent with a training center in Saxbahaw. However, I'd rather talk about to you about the noise pollution and safety issues that would affect my family and other community members. From my house, I can already hear the garbage trucks beeping all day, as well as the phone ringing on a loudspeaker for some reason at the landfill. The current landfill is considerably further away from my house than the potential training center location, and so the additional sounds of sirens and trucks and a driving track and gunshots would be heartbreaking. On top of that, I know on Google Maps it looks like there's a lot, not much out in our section of the county, but there really are people who live out there. We have lives and families out there. I have two children, Owen, who is 3 years old, and Eleanor, who is 8 months old. Sorry. I want them to feel and be safe in our woods. I'm sure that every precaution would be made to assure people's safety, but would you let your children climb in the backyard while you listen to the gunshots ring through those same trees? I suggest that if you believe that another training facility is needed in Alamance County, we consider other locations and evaluate where this facility would best serve our county. Maybe there is a community in Alamance County that would benefit from housing this facility. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Raines. Doug Williams.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Thank you for your attention to my thoughts relative to the proposed training facility on Austin Quarter Road. My name is Doug Williams. I have lived and worked in Alamance County for over 25 years. I'm a resident of Saxbahaw. I live in the recently repurposed Upper Mill development. I am the financial investor in the Upper Mill commercial and residential condo project. I'm also an owner of several business entities within Saxbahaw, as well as an energetic and financial backer of several village startup businesses. Additionally, I own a business within 4 miles of the proposed site that employs over 400 people, not all of which live in Alamance County, but many of which do. My only point here is to point out that I plan to live here the rest of my life. I pay taxes and I provide jobs. I have several brief points. I very much appreciate and support our law enforcement and emergency response personnel, and will continue to do so regardless of the outcome of this decision. I am not qualified or informed enough at this point to reach any conclusion as to Alamance County's needs for this training center, but I trust in the knowledge and needs of those professionals. I do not believe that locating the training center on Austin Quarter Road is in the best interest of the community, the local residents, the farmers, or the county itself. I am not comfortable attempting to speak to where this should be located, but I trust that there are certainly less delicate and potentially less harmful locations to consider. As many of you commissioners know firsthand, Saxbahaw and its people have been a bright success in Alamance County's recent history, developing well over 60 permanent jobs, not counting the temporary construction jobs, bringing positive regional, state, and national recognition, regularly serving as a destination for out-of-county visitors and revenue. The brand of Saxbahaw has helped put Alamance County on the map as it relates to reuse, renovation, migration back to the village core, sustainable farming, trails, natural and environmental pursuits, green development, education, farm-to-fork culinary reputation, as well as a nationally recognized event and music venue, all of which is on the cutting edge of a national and a global movement and trend that will define the success and future of our communities and our nation. In closing, I do not believe this facility should be in the Saxbahaw community. With all due respect, my opinion is that for Alamance County to do anything that may risk missing the opportunity to fully embrace, support, and benefit from the great potential that Saxbahaw is now and will become would fail to live up to the standard of care we people have placed in your hands. And locating this training center in this location would create such a risk. Thank you for your attention to this important matter.
Thank you, Mr. William. Yeah. Mike Curry.
I'm afraid that's me, baby. It's Kelly. Commissioners, I know you got a lot of people waiting. I'm going to be very brief. I'm not here to speak the logistics of this matter, to the economics of this matter, but I want to address the integrity of the matter. I read recently that the county made a promise to the previous landowners when we took this property that they would have lifetime rights to farm that property. Now, whether that promise was made with a handshake or if it was reduced to writing in contract, we owe that family to stand by our word. And that's all I wanted to say tonight on that issue. Thank you.
Thank you, Mike. Mr. Oxley?
Laurel?
Yeah, Laurel.
Thank you. I'm Laurel Holtz Oxley, and I live in Haw Village down by Saks Fifth. The author of a letter that was published yesterday in a local newspaper regarding the proposed Saxbahaw location for a new emergencies training center requested that those with concern about the location offer, quote, data that rationally measures and analyzes how developing these 87 acres would threaten the safety and well-being of people that live in the area. Here are just a few of the items to consider. The author remarked that he lives by a rock quarry and therefore he understands our concerns about a facility. My husband and I also lived by a rock quarry for 22 years, and we are well aware of the generally once daily detonation that occurs during regular business hours. But such a situation pales to the use of a training center, which necessitates large plumes of fire and smoke, noisy vehicles exceeding over 100 decibels, day, evening, night, and weekend procedures that run for many hours, sniper fire traveling long distances, significant overuse of an already taxed water system that has no sewer supply, and use of various amounts of fuels and chemicals near the Haw River. You don't need to take my comments on this at face value. You can view the schedules online for the numerous facilities of this type already in use in our local area to see when and how they are used, as well as many videos. The author also said that the quote-unquote few folks that live within a mile or two of the proposed facility should be considered. Actually, there are over 250 families living within 1 mile. As of the last census, there were 1,648 people living within Saxbahaw and hundreds more in the direct vicinity. Approximately $19.5 million of new residential real estate development activities are underway or planned within approximately a mile of the proposed facility. That amount of county tax revenue will be seriously damaged and in many cases completely lost if the Saxbahaw site is used. We already have very noisy garbage trucks going through our area all day, bringing the entire county's trash here when they don't have to see it anymore. That surely is enough. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, Ms. Ock. Mike Howard.
Harwood.
I'm sorry, Mr. Harwood.
That's all right. Commissioners, Mr. Chair, my name is Mike Harwood. I'm a registered professional engineer in the state of North Carolina. I have a bachelor's degree in civil engineering from Michigan Tech University and a master's from UNC Charlotte, as well as 20 years of experience as an engineering consultant, mostly for private real estate developers. The best real estate developers that I've worked with, when they're looking to invest millions of dollars in a facility in the hope of getting a return on investment, what they always look for is a sense of place. If you consider the auto parts store, the O'Reilly, the Advanced Autos, they're always clustered together. They always go where their competitors are. Drugstore, CVS, Walgreens, they're always together. You name it, restaurants, hotels, they always cluster together. The reason is that developers understand that people have a very strong sense of place. They go, if they need auto parts, they go to where the auto parts are, not to a particular store. If you're looking to build a facility here in the hopes of drawing people from out of town or from out of state to do training for revenue purposes, I can tell you that it's a risk. There's no history of training in Saxbaha. There's nothing to tell people from out of town that Saxbaha is the place to come and do fire or police training. There's no background for that. Saxbaha, however, does have a very strong sense of place, and it's been touched on here with the tourist business. I've got here a download from the New York Times travel section on Saxbaha. I don't know how many other communities in Alamance County have had write-ups in the New York Times, but Saxbaha has. There are similar articles in the Washington Post and the LA Times on Saxbaha, North Carolina. It is a national draw. People come from all over. They bring their children, they bring their families. They go to the puppet show in Saxbaha. They might go paddle on the Haw River. They might go to the Eddie Pub for dinner. They might go to the Haw River Ballroom for an event or to have a wedding. People come from all over, and when they come here, they stay at hotels in Burlington. They have dinner at Alamance Crossing. They go shopping at the outlet stores in Mebane. There is a sense of place here. If we want to invest in Alamance County, if we want to invest in Saxbaha, the smart real estate money is to invest on what's already begun. The seeds have been planted for growth in Saxbaha, and there is a real revenue stream coming from Saxbaha. If what you want to do is invest and get a return on investment, don't destroy the seeds that have been planted in the hopes of if you build it, they will come. Real estate does not work that way. You build on what we already have. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Howard. Judy Ward. And the following people, if you would get in line: James Ingold, Britt Smith, Bobby Ingold, and Cheryl Braswell.
Mr. Chairman of the Commissioners, I would just like to share some my thoughts with you on the Emergency Service Regional Center. I feel like that none of us can get too much training. I feel like if you go into a training area that they're offering training in your profession, it always benefits you in some way. We need to look long and hard about bringing it to Alamance County, because if we have a regional center here, we're going to bring people from outside of our county in here that's going to help our economic growth. They're going to spend the night, they're going to eat meals, they're going to buy gas, they're going to do a lot of things that will benefit this county. And our law enforcement, our fire department, and our EMTs are not the most well-paid people anyway. This is one way that we can help train them to do a better job for us. They're doing it for us. And I hope that we can approve this project when it comes up for approval. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, Ms. Ward. James Ingold.
Friday, January the 17th, I read an article in the Burlington Times News which says Sheriff Terry Johnson has been talking about a training center for all the counties, law enforcement, and emergency workers since 2002. But the idea seems to be getting some momentum lately. I can tell you all the fire chiefs in the county are on board with this, said David Leonard, Alamance County Fire Marshal and Emergency Services Coordinator. Johnson said he wants to build a training center for emergency responders on 87 acres of county property next door to the Alamance County landfill. At that time, I figured it would be on the right side of Austin Quarter Road, somewhere in the area of the landfill. I was in town that day when my nephew, Matt Ingold, called me and said it was to be on the land that we farmed. I decided to go to the sheriff's office to see if Terry Johnson was in to see where it would be. I got to meet with Terry Johnson, and he said, "Come look at this map and I will show you." He showed me the first field on the left, which is 4 acres open land. He said he wanted to start here first and do 30 or 35 acres to start with. Then he showed me the other field, which we farm, that is strip cropped. It has 7 strips in it. He asked me how much I had, how much land I had. I told him. Then what really surprised me when he said, I didn't want to do anything to hurt our farmers. If this passes, this takes away our future in the dairy business. We need this land for our crops and also a place to spread manure from the dairy farm. I'm 62 years old and have worked on this farm my entire life, getting up between 2:30 and 3 a.m. 7 days a week to milk our cows. Terry and myself both graduated from Southern in 1969. I have worked on this farm every day. What I can't understand is Terry says he doesn't want to hurt our farmers, but he is willing to take away our future in the dairy business. In 2012, there was 153,900 people in Alamance County. In 2013, this farm produced 224,878 gallons of milk. That would be equal to 1.5 gallons of milk for every person in Alamance County. Remember, none of us would be here if it wasn't for our farmers. James Engel, just a farmer, plain and simple.
Thank you, Mr. Engel. Rich Smith.
This is going to be an impromptu speech. I'm Rich Smith. I'm nobody. This is a picture of me riding down the Hall River. Enjoying it. They're trying to make a greenway through there. I agree with the farmers. What I mean to say is that if the Times News and this council would give the people of Alamance County a chance to look around and find that perfect site of 100 acres, because it exists, I know it exists, they would have the lay of the land to where you would not hear the noise. They could have bombs go off and it wouldn't bother anybody. You have your own 3 sources of water, a lake, 2 rivers, and a deep artesian well. It's pure water, not polluted like happens all the time. Our guys, our law enforcement, they don't need to be drugged with future terrorists in the water supply. They need their mind to keep their training that they're going to get. This place would be wonderful. Allows for a tower being built. It would be cheaper than paying the lawyers to do all this stuff. It would preserve the values that we have for the family farms. It wouldn't upset the cows. Instead of listening to guns, they could listen to Elvis and have more music. Now, sir, I'd like to thank you on behalf of the people for letting everybody speak. My name is on the back.
Thank you. Do you want this back?
No.
Pass it down.
I would like to ask everybody here, there seems to be a trend, not my neighborhood, and I totally agree. I have experienced a lot in my life, and I was grateful to hear the prayers we could barely hear on this meeting. We respect the law officers, the counties, the mothers with the kids that want to go over there and see what's going on when they're shooting. You have to watch everybody. It's too near the neighborhood. The place I'm proposing is away from that. It's a private entrance. It would be safe for law enforcement. They would have the freedom to do trails, climb ditches, water, rescue, everything. And I would like a chance for the people of this county to look around and talk to their neighbors, not Saxbaha, not Swepsonville, but to find that place. Maybe a drug lord, take his land and turn it into something good. Bust them, I don't care. You know, the land I'm talking about, just holding the world together. It's not good for any real estate except certain places where you could build what you wanted. It would be historically preservation of an old, established, wonderful, well-respected family.
Thank you, Ms. Smith. Thank you very much. Bobby Engel.
I guess I'm going to speak more for my uncle that's not here anymore. And this is not, he would be turning double back flips right now if he knew we were in here discussing this. Because he just loved that farm that bad. And it's just a bad situation. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Engel. Cheryl Braswell and the following people, if you would come forward. It looks like Lee Clayton, Stephen Duran, Suzanne Nelson, Sue Dayton, and Linda Burnham. Go right ahead.
Thank you. Hi, commissioners and county officials, and thank you for allowing everybody to speak and be heard, because we all do have an opinion. I'm Cheryl Braswell, and I first of all want to say I am in favor of a training facility if we need one in our county. I don't know how much research has been done. I don't have that much information, but I do know that I love Saxbaha, and I love the farms. And when I moved there, I didn't know what I was even moving into. I've lived there for 20 years. And for those people that don't live in the country, it's hard to value that. But we have a lot of people come to our home who really treasure the peace and quiet and the sanctuary of nature. And we want to preserve that. I want to say that I voted for you and appreciate all the hard work that you have all done and do for us. My family is also grateful for the support we've received from the EMT personnel and other county officials. We want the staff to have the training they need to do their jobs well. But I'm asking you to give serious consideration to not putting the training center near Saxbaha. I'm a resident of the Saxbaha area. I love the small town, the country feeling here where my children grew up, living close to the land, learning where their food came from and how to grow it, and animals also. We're proud of our small farms, providing quality food to neighbors and others, demonstrating how villages used to live a long time ago. We're an example of that. Our example of conscious and caring living is calling more and more visitors to the area, and folks are making their homes there because of the small, quiet town and friendly atmosphere. I hope you've all been to Saxbaha and checked it out. Saxbaha is something special that Alamance County can be proud of, and we stand out nationally, as it's been pointed out, in a very positive way. I hope you'll recognize the jewel that Saxbaha is and make wise decisions to keep it productive, to keep our small farming community growing and remaining safe for children and all people. You know, we will be a national example of renewing resources and protecting the land and environment. I trust you'll put yourselves in our places and ask yourself, would you want this facility next door to you? Think about the impact it'll have on the community and the environment. We have a landfill already and a medical waste facility. Please let that be enough for Saxbaha. There are more suitable areas for the EMT training facility than Saxbaha, and I hope that you will all look into that and find the best location if you need one. And thank you for hearing us.
Thank you, Ms. Brown. Hey, is it Leighton?
Yeah, my name is Leah. Can people hear me?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you so much for letting everybody talk. I really appreciate it.
What's your name?
My name is Leah Clayton. I live on Whitney Road in Saxbaha for the past 12 years with my husband Donovan, who's here, and my beautiful 2-year-old daughter, who I'm totally in love with, who's the center of my world. So we have 15 acres on Whitney Road, and we are opposed to the training center being presented by the sheriff. I believe it's not a good use for these 87 acres, and it's not a good fit for our community. We live a few hundred yards from the landfill, right across the river. On our land, we have chickens, bees, a small orchard, and raise some of our own food. My husband and I also, we each own businesses in the town center of Saxbaha. And we have made Alamance County our home, and we're proud to be raising our family here. When I think about my daughter, Althea, growing up there on the land and being part of Alamance County, it feels really good to me. And I just want to say to the emergency responders and police and fire professionals who dedicate themselves to keeping us all safe and alive, it's really important that you know that I really, really appreciate your work and keeping me safe and alive and my daughter. If something happened at my home, I know that they need to be well-trained. So I really hope that nothing that I say goes against how I really feel about their work, courage, and their sacrifice. I think that there are a lot of different points that can be made, and I think one thing that people haven't discussed yet today is the Mountains to Sea Trail. I'm sure you're aware that there's an easement that goes through there, and I just wanted to mention that that doesn't really seem, this center, seem a compatible use for parkland going through there. It's a really exciting project to think about, the trail. And I also wanted to say I graduated from the Central Carolina Community College Farming Program in Pittsburgh when it first got started. And I think it'd be really great to have something like that there on that land. Since we have such the community seeds planted for training farmers and training gardeners. I know that Alamance Community College is really interested in finding public land to teach farmers on. It's a really great site in Saxbaha because we already are really interested in that connection between growing the food and preparing it and selling it and eating it all there. The network is there. The other day I was walking down by the river with my husband and my daughter, and there's a family from Raleigh that came out and they said, oh, after church we didn't have anything to do and we wanted to check out Saxbaha. What's to do in Saxbaha? So they had decided to eat dinner at the Eddie and at our little store to have lunch there. And so we said, well, you can go to the antique store. Well, you really should come back in the summer when we have lots of people come to our farmers market and hear music. And when I think about the training center, it just really doesn't seem like a good fit with all that. So, and also I'm frightened about the toxic fumes that my daughter would be breathing every day. I mean, really, that's terrifying. And what would a mother do but stand here? So, anyway.
Thank you, Ms. Clayton. At Stephen, is it Duran?
Durland. Close.
Good.
Thank you for giving us all a chance to speak, and as a result, condense this to return the favor a little bit. My wife and I and her son have been living on Austin Quarter Road for 20 years on 28 acres. I felt it was really important to come here and say that just because when I hear proponents of this facility talking about the Austin Quarter Road project, there's this sense that there's nobody there. And when I look at my place on Google Maps, it's about 1,300 feet. My home is 1,300 feet from this. As a full-time artist and designer, I work out of my home, have all this time. I entertain clients there. I meet with potential customers there. I have a separate gallery where I display and sell my work. And I have a permanent installation of outdoor art in the woods that has become a local tourist attraction. In just the past year, I've had folks visit from Mississippi, Georgia, Florida, Michigan, Massachusetts, and more. When these people visit, hopefully they buy art, because I do this for a living. It's not a hobby. So you can well imagine why I'm concerned when I hear about putting a driving track, a firing range, a fire tower, a burn facility, and more close enough so that I can see it, I can hear it, I can smell it, and I don't hear any mention of limitations. So I'm worried because it sounds like this could easily ruin my business and in all likelihood have a very negative effect on my property value. We moved here 20 years ago because we love this piece of property, and we still do. And while some people find it hard to believe, we found the landfill to be a good neighbor. And over the years, I hope we've been good neighbors in return. But expecting us to welcome this proposed facility is asking too much. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Suzanne Nelson.
My name is Suzanne Nelson, and I'm the owner of Cozy Farms. The other night, around 11:30 at night, I got a call from a neighbor. She wanted to know if my daughter and her father were okay. And I said, I don't know. She said, what's going on Lloydtown Road? And I said, I don't know. She said, I've seen at least 15 fire trucks go down that road in the last 5 minutes. I was 5 miles away, and I drove my truck as fast as I could to get there. And there's only about 4 houses on Lloydtown Road, and one of them is where this little girl sleeps. And I drove past our house, her father's house, and the house was dark and quiet and peaceful. That whole ride up the road, I thought that there may be a fireman pulling my daughter out of a burning home. I was very grateful at that moment that those individuals were trained and cared for. As I rolled down the hill, I thought that the whole Lloyd Dairy was on fire. That's how much red light there was coming from over the horizon. It had turned out that Carson and Clayton's tractor had caught on fire, and my prayer had been answered. Nobody was hurt. Not a soul, not a cow, not a blade of hay, not a barn. I lived in D.C. during and after 9/11, and I've seen a lot of fire personnel in one place before, and I have to say it was a pretty impressive display, even for me. Carrboro, Swepsonville, people have come from all over. I was very grateful to be part of this rural community at that time. I moved to Saxbaha for a reason. I chose from lots of places. I actually went on a tour of the country because I wanted to live someplace really great. And I chose here. I chose to raise my daughter here. I chose to start a farm here. When I was taking Vivian to the bathroom just now before coming up to speaking, she said, "Mama, may I speak?" And I said, "No." And then I stopped myself and I said, "Vivian, what do you want to say?" And she said, "I want to talk about raising food for people and how it nourishes them. Last year we raised about 2,500 meat birds. We had 800 laying hens. I have about 30 dairy cows and calves, about 200 sheep. Last year we raised about 150 turkeys. We feed people, and I'm proud of the food that we feed them. We've worked with a farmer in Elon to develop a locally milled organic feed that's it's the only place in the region that's available. Our food is very clean, and we're very, very proud of it. Do you guys know, after the Chernobyl disaster in Russia, how the radiation poisoning killed people? Through cow's milk. Cows are incredible bioaccumulators of toxins. They're an animal that's bred to produce 4 times more milk than their baby needs. That means they're sort of like high-octane race cars. The Ingolds can speak to that better than I. They've been farmers much longer than I. But I can tell you that cows are incredibly delicate animals, and to seat this facility across from them poisons not only me and my daughter and my cows, but all the people who eat our food. And I ask you to think about putting something 1,000 feet from animals that are so sensitive. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Nelson. Sue Dayton.
Good evening, commissioners. Good evening. Can you hear me? Okay. I'd like to thank you, especially Commissioner Sutton, for letting us all speak tonight. It's very important.
It was our total board.
Thank you, everyone, and thank you for coming up with the idea. How's that? My name is Susan Dayton. I'm a resident and a business owner in Saxbaha, and I'm representing myself here today in stating my opposition to the EMT training facility currently being proposed for Saxbaha. Many of the old towns in our counties today stand empty and discarded, hollow shells of their former existence. Saxpaw is not one of these. It has determinedly struggled over the past several years to become what it is today, a mill town with a makeover, a popular tourist destination, a rural retreat and getaway where visitors travel statewide and beyond, not only to explore Saxpaw's past, but to partake in Saxpaw's current and revitalized homegrown economy. Tourists come to Saxbaha to eat good food, listen to music at outdoor concerts, do wine tasting at the local vineyard, shop for art, tour historic homes and antique shops, and spend a night or two at a local bed and breakfast on the river. They come to canoe and kayak on the Haw, see the GBHs, that's short for great blue herons, egrets, osprey, and even bald eagles. Burning pillars of acrid smoke and flames 200 feet tall, shooting from helicopters at ground targets from the air, gunshots heard for miles around echoing off the river, a sniper range, burn house, driving track, helicopter shooting range in close proximity to Saxpa will have a deleterious effect on our local economy. It will impact our quality of life in the village, and it will impact our businesses. Some residents, like the Durland family, you just heard from Steve, live as close as, I've got 1,200 feet, but he said 1,300 feet to the proposed training facility. There are at least two farms located in close proximity to the proposed facility that you've heard about that supply our local restaurants with meat and produce that would likely be forced to close operations because of impacts to farming. Therefore, I respectfully request that alternative locations be explored for the siting of this facility or in partnership with one of several other law enforcement training facilities located within easing drive-in distance of Alamance County. But please, not in Saxbaha. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ms. Dayton. Linda Burnham and the following people, if you would, please come forward. John Worthington, Lee Johnson, Jane and James McPhail, and David Holtz Oxley. Ms. Burnham.
Hi. I understand why it appears that the Saxbaha site near the landfill would be a reasonable choice for the proposed training facility. Some people assume that nobody lives out there. But I and my family live out there, and we have for two decades. My husband and my son and I live a quarter mile away from that site. We live and work here every day. Everything we have is invested in our land. The dollar value of it means everything to us. Its value will always be kept fairly low because we live close to the landfill. But it's all we have. It's our nest egg. It's what we would rely on in case of financial disaster. I have seen photos and videos of a police training facility in use, and there is no doubt in my mind that the noise, smoke, and night lights will make my neighborhood unlivable and will drastically decrease our property value. Please don't let this happen to us. If reliable studies show that we need another police training facility in Alamance, please don't put it in my neighborhood. It will break my heart.
Thank you, Ms. Burnham. John Worthington.
Good evening. I'm John Worthington. As you know, I was here for the last county commissioners meeting when I had first read this in the paper. And I hope we will soon get more information about this in the form of a proposal so we'll know what we are talking about specifically. There's been mention of the farms, businesses in Saxbaha. My wife and I moved there 25 years ago because we like a rural area. It has changed quite a bit in the last 25 years and in a positive way, which has already been mentioned very well. One of the things I'm concerned about is the children in the area. I have grandchildren, not in the area, but I am sensitive to children. I have substituted since I retired from working at UNC at the school through the three different River Mill, Hall Bridge School, and the first, I forget the name of the school that it was, but those kids spend a lot of time outdoors and learning, outdoor learning is part of their learning ability. They spend a lot of time on the river. The B. Everett Jordan School is nearby, and we have recently have a child care center at the Methodist Church. There's the other church, the Baptist Church nearby, has an outdoor facility, has playgrounds, lots of activities for its members and children at their services. We don't know from the information we have now how often this facility would be used, if it was going to be night, day, weekends, Saturdays, Sundays, all day when people are out with their children. And I just can't imagine the impact that this may have on school children during their in the classroom or outside. And I just am very concerned about the impact on the children, as well as the residents there. And I hope to spend the rest of my life in Saxbahaw, and my wife and I, and I want it to be a nice, peaceful place. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Worthington. Lee Johnson.
Hello.
Hello.
So I'm pretty agitated and emotional because I want to preserve the serenity of the river. I've invested my time and money in creating a little business for myself, a livelihood, and I have chosen to live right on the river. I live between Saxbahaw and Swepsonville, and I have a small massage business in Saxbahaw. And all of the business owners in Saxbahaw have been working quite diligently to create an ecotourism destination, and I think we've been successful. And I can see that it will continue to grow. And so I'm interested in protecting my investment of my time and my money and my energy. And I'm interested in protecting what we've been able to build. And I can see there's a lot of potential there. And I see this facility as an economic threat to my livelihood and also to my personal well-being and health. I'm hoping that you can find an appropriate site to place this. I want to be safe. But I also want to be treated with respect. Everybody wants to feel safe, and everybody wants to be treated with respect. And so I'm hoping that you all will take into consideration what kind of impact this is going to have on the people who are living and working in Saxbahaw, and be respectful of us. I want to enjoy the river. I want to feel like I can go out safely and that there's not going to be hidden health dangers. I want people to come and visit Saxbahaw and enjoy it and to be rejuvenated by the serenity of the site. There's something really special about the river there. I feel it. I don't know if I could make you feel it, but if you were to come and visit, you might. This area used to be industrial, which is why it may have been considered for a site like this. But it's not industrial anymore. It's farms and residences, and there's a very beautiful community growing in Saxbahaw that is a gem. And I really treasure it. I'm so agitated. I didn't want to have to be so overwrought, and I apologize for that, but it's only because it's important to me. So I hope that I have conveyed that. Please excuse me for being emotional.
Thank you, Ms. Johnson. Is it Jane McPhail? Folks, you all have been very gracious and courteous, and I appreciate that. This three-minute bell that rings, I'm an old artillery man, and I don't hear too well at all, so I may miss it. So, Sherry, if you give me a wave, because it's an alarm clock for me to hear it, I guess. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Thank you. My name is Janet McFall. I live on Whitney Road in near Saxbahaw. And I'd like to address the proposed Alamance County training facility and whether or not it is the best use for the land that's being considered in Austin Quarter. It's a rapidly growing commercial area, as you know, and has already been addressed with the Eddy Pub, the Hall River Ballroom, and regional farms. It's recognized nationally as a destination. And when I teach abroad, and I've had people emailing me when I'm abroad saying, did you see the article of the New York Times about where you live? It's a place that people value and treasure. The Mountains to Sea Trail is a major project in North Carolina extending from the mountains to the coast. The proposed trail route is to go down the Haw River right past the landfill and then up Cane Creek to meet the River State Park. Parts of the trail have already been constructed in northern Alamance County, and last summer there were 74,000 people who visited that trail, even though it's not completed. That's a lot of people coming to Alamance County. As the trail continues and it's brought down into Saxbaha, it's likely that the usage will even be greater than that. And so I ask, is that the memory that we want people to take away from their visit to Alamance County? I live across the river, and I can hear the landfill like it's in my backyard. They're very good neighbors, but the sound travels. My husband and I like to target shoot, and our neighbors always tell us when they can hear our sounds. And so sound travels. Do we want people who have visited our trail to go home remembering the gunfire and the explosions, and that's the memory that they bring home from Alamance County? I don't think so. Also, it's a very good area for agriculture. The average net farm income in North Carolina right now is $63,000. The soils that are in that part of the county are very good soils for agriculture. They are Davidson clay loam and Tursa silt loam, which are both considered statewide high-value soils for agriculture. Is this the best use for that land? So I just wanted to conclude by saying, are there other uses that we might consider? For agricultural training, perhaps with the Alamance Community College, a farm incubator program. We're preparing to start one in Guilford County, and starting one in Alamance County would be quite an asset. Are there other things that this land could be used for? It's being held in public trust for the people of Alamance County, and perhaps we can think through what the best use might be for this site, and if there are other places that might be more appropriate for the training facility. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you, Ms. McFaul. Is it James McFaul?
I just want to thank you all for hearing all of these extended comments. I am married to the previous speaker, and I support fully what she said. It's very quiet out in Saxapaha. All of what the other speakers have said about the quality of life out there shows that Saxapaha has done something good for Alamance County. We are happy neighbors of the landfill, which is one of the first really clean landfills. It's been managed very well. It doesn't disturb us. There's occasional recreational shooting out in Alamance County where we are, but it's nothing like what would happen with military weapons, helicopters, black smoke plumes polluting the air and the surroundings. It would be best to find this facility somewhere else, because we want to support our firefighters and police and emergency personnel. I'm very glad you're looking into that, but there must be other areas in Alamance County that will allow Saxapaha to thrive and to accomplish this goal. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. McFaul. David Holtz Oxley. And if the following people would please come forward. It looks like Julia starts with a C, I think, but I can't read. James Fletcher, Matt Deal, and Lee Hall Worley, and Max Lazar. Yes, sir, Mr.
Hey, thank you very much for taking the time to hear us, and really appreciate it. My wife and I moved into the Saxapaha area. We're relatively new. We've been there since, I guess, last March. I'd gotten a job in Greensboro, but we found Saxapaha when we were looking for a house, and decided it's worth it for me to drive 50 minutes each way every day, because Saxapaha is just that special. Sorry. I want to try to not cover things, you know, respect your wishes. It doesn't mean I don't feel just as strongly about some of the issues like water and things like that, but those have been covered already. I do want you to know I don't understand how this can be considered the premium site in the county at this point. There's several concerns if you just look at the land. 15 acres of this 89 acres or whatever is a swamp. it's not even farmed, much less available for, you know, how are they going to fill up a swamp? I'm a bit of a nerd. I'm a total nerd, okay? I love to look at things on Google Maps with the satellite view. I've looked at an awful lot. There are 10 other facilities. Yes, sir. I hope that makes sense. I can explain it if it's
I'll tell you what it is later, yeah.
Okay.
All right, go ahead.
But I've looked at a lot of sites within, there's 10 other sites within 90 miles of here that are different sorts of, you know, different training facilities from very small to very, very large. And within those facilities, one thing stuck out to me. They're all flat. This piece of land is nowhere close to flat. There's huge elevation changes. Now, I know you can pour things in, you can tear down mountains, you can fill up valleys. I understand that. But that's not what this piece of land is. That's not what this part of the of our county is. It's rolling land. That's how it was meant to be. Lastly, I don't know if any of you have seen the video of the Burlington City Council meeting a couple of weeks ago, but the sheriff was presenting the proposal, and one of their council members asked the police chief and the fire chief if they thought that they would spend much time using this facility. And I really encourage you to go pull up that video on your own, but the answer was, for daily things, no, we might use it for special annual kinds of things. But if they don't even want to go from Burlington to Saxbahaw because it would pull units too far out of their district, the idea that this is going to be a regional center where people are pulling things from other counties, other states, you know, from distances away, doesn't make sense. Okay? I think if we need the facility, great. I would really like it to be considered. The Burlington facility apparently has some drawbacks to it. But, you know, Asheville and Buncombe County spent over the last 4 years $15 million building a site to do this very same thing. And it seems like at this point, if we can fix the site, if we can upgrade the site, it's hard for me to believe that we couldn't do a better job with the Burlington site, where they're already dealing with these issues, they already have things in place to do it, as opposed to starting over from scratch in a place where I just don't think it fits very well. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Dodge. Julia Childs? Is it Childs? Julia Childs?
Julia.
Julia?
Julia.
Is it Childs?
I'm Julia Hicks. Is that who you're calling? I don't have the cleanest handwriting. Well, my name is Julia Hicks. I live 5 minutes from Saxbahaw. I want to thank you for listening to the people of this area and appreciate your giving us the time to speak today. And I also appreciate the service that you provide. I know it's a lot. It's a real dedication. Thank you. I am supportive of ambulance drivers and firefighters being well trained. I have called upon their services. My family has called upon their services, and friends also in times of crisis. And I sincerely appreciate their service and dedication to safety and well-being of our community. But that being said, as a resident of Alamance County, just 5 minutes from Saxbahaw, I am distressed that a training facility is being proposed so close to downtown Saxbahaw. I've had an incident recently which I'd like to share with you so you can understand why I feel it would decrease the safety in our town were that to pass. But first I would like to tell you that one of the things I love about Saxbahaw is that they like Paris, France, we offer free bicycles to folks who can borrow the bikes and then return them at will. It's a wonderful thing that we do for the community. So I was recently driving across the bridge near the mill, going towards town on a beautiful sunny day. The speed limit's about 30 miles an hour. You can't go fast through there. I drove over the bridge, and I slowed down over the bridge, and then I saw that at the curb to the right was a moving van in a loading zone. And the back end of the truck was just shy of jutting out into the street, so I slowed down even more as I approached the curve, and my vision was completely blocked for the road beyond. And to my great alarm, as I rounded the bend, I spied a young man on a bicycle, pushing his way up the bike, back and forth. So so I slammed on my brakes to keep from contacting him. Fortunately, I was able to divert a deadly accident. There's no room to get around. There was no room for me to get around him. There was no time either. So I hoped for a second that he would pull over, but he didn't. He stayed in the middle of the road until he reached the first entrance, the entrance to the ballroom. And I'm glad I'm telling you this story instead of speaking this in front of a judge, defending myself in front of a judge, okay? I really was very frightened when this happened. The road through Saxapaw cannot sustain heavy trucks. I ask you to vote against the proposal. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Hicks. James Fletcher?
Members of the council. My name is James Fletcher. I'm a resident of Saxbahall. Bobby Ingold and the Ingold family is a good friend of mine, and I may offend a bunch of my friends and family in Saxbahall, but I am for the proposed multi-purpose training facility in Saxbahall. I'm a father, a farmer, and a red-leg veteran. I have talked to several residents of Saxapahaw, and we would like to request that you make a few adjustments to the facility and grounds to both protect the environment and to serve our local community. Please consider moving the training facility to the unused area of the current landfill on Austin Quarters. There's plenty of land down there. They're only occupying a small bit of it. Continue to uphold the promise to the Ingolds of Lifetime Farm at their place. There's not enough of us left. And the Ingolds would be the first person that I would go to if I ever needed any help. And I have. And they've always, middle of the night, early in the morning, stopped what they were doing to help me. We need to honor the promise that our community gave them. Secondly, while under construction, I would like you to build some walking tracks. Build a community rec center with weights, card tables, checker tables, soccer, and baseball fields. Build a containment ditches for fuel spills and runoff from the burned buildings. Buildings and target ranges should be accessible to all. Monthly training by local police officers for control or concealed carry and basic marksmanship. A public skeet range for hunters education instruction and school competitions. A lot of schools in Alamance County participate in the hunters education shooting range. Access to the running and physical fitness area by the public. No sirens or shooting after 11 p.m. No shooting or sirens or fires before 12 o'clock on Sunday. No volatile chemicals used in fires without checking the wind is blowing in the direction of the River Mill School. Our children don't need to breathe it. Minimal use of rubber and plastics in the training burns. Hire locals. Terry, please hire the locals. We need some more work out there. Sheriff. An archery range and a skeet range for hunters' education to further our. Thank you for hearing me. All these requests are feasible and reasonable to the county at a minimum cost. Thank you, and God bless America.
Thank you for your service.
Thank you, Mr. Fletcher.
Thanks, sir.
Matt Deal.
Good evening. My name is Matt Deal. I am a resident of Saxapahaw on Whitney Road and also a business owner on Whitney Road. I have a bed and breakfast just across the river from the landfill. I also want to thank the commissioners for giving everyone a chance to speak tonight. I certainly can appreciate the fact that are EMTs, firefighters, and police officers may require a training facility. I have both extended family and immediate family who work in law enforcement and firefighting and have the utmost respect for the work that they do. But I obviously have some concerns as a parent and a business owner about how this facility might impact the health and well-being of my family, my neighbors, and impact the business that I currently run and have run for the past 7 years. I guess really the bottom line is, if there's a need for a facility such as this, there, I would hope, are some alternative sites that could be considered. I know Swepsonville has also been talked about, but these are the only two sites I'm aware of to this point. With all of the local residents and businesses that have spoken tonight, not only the Hallbridge School, but B. Everett Jordan Elementary School, just have some serious concerns about why the facility would be located with so much dense population, so many small businesses, and two schools within probably 2 miles of the facility, proposed facility. I think Janet and some other folks have mentioned the possibilities of other uses for the land. I certainly hope those would be considered. We have a number of small farmers who have been in business out there for a long time. An agriculture extension through the community college seems like it would be a wonderful use for the property. Perhaps a small business training facility through the community college. There are a number, probably 25 to 30 small business owners within a couple of miles of the mill and this proposed facility. That could be another use for the property. So, I don't know. I just ask that these things be taken into consideration when planning goes forward, and that we also are provided with some more information about what exactly would take place at the proposed facility. Thanks again for your time.
Thank you, Mr. Deal. Lee Hall Worley?
Worthington.
Worthington.
Yes.
Looks just like
that. I know. I hadn't learned that. Thank you, County Commissioners. Thank you, Mr. Sutton, for advocating for us to speak, and thank you to the board for allowing us. My husband and I have lived in Saxbaha since 1989. Since that time, I have worked in Alamance County and served on numerous boards. Some of my work that I have done have intersected with law enforcement. Getting training and things like that. So I have had a close relationship with law enforcement. I have an investment in the community and in this county. I love living in Saxbaha. When I moved here in 1989, this was before cell phones, I used to tell people when I was giving them directions to Saxbaha, now if you get lost and you find a payphone, then you're really lost, because we didn't even have a store there. The mill was operating at the time at partial capacity, and a few years later, the mill did close. It sat empty for the longest time. Now, thanks to the collaboration of creative entrepreneurs and energetic people, Saxbaha has been reinvented while preserving the integrity of this historic mill town. We have eating establishments, a farmer's market, and a music venue that have state, regional, and national acknowledgement. The way has been opened to create a new array of small businesses and enhanced businesses that are rooted in this area of the county. Folks are coming to find permanent residents. Others come for day trips to explore and take walks by the river. My husband and I enjoy being able to walk to the store to have a bite to eat or just to enjoy the serenity of the river. No more fights about whether we're going to Chapel Hill or Burlington. Which place are we going to? For me, there is a greater sense of connection to the community because we get to get out and meet people. In my travels, I often meet people who, upon learning where I am from, say, I love Saxbaha, or I've heard so much about it, or I wished I lived there. Saxbahaw is no longer just a shortcut for log trucks to travel between Highway 54 and Highway 87. It is a destination to a picturesque village located on the Haw River. I fear that the noise pollution and the chaos created by the deployment of training exercises at the proposed facility will compromise the atmosphere of the village. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Max Lazarus.
Hi, my name is Max Lazarus, and I want to thank you all for volunteering to hear everybody out and stay up a little bit later here this evening to hear everybody. My wife and I moved to Eli Whitney area, just on the other side of the river from Saxapaw, about 5 years or so after looking for land in Chatham County, Orange County, and Alamance County for approximately 2 years. We found a beautiful vacant piece of land. It had always been my dream to build my own house and start a family, which is what we ended up doing. I have a 5-year-old daughter, and when we came to Saxapaw, we had a feeling that there was something really positive happening in Saxapaw, and we didn't even really know what it was. It was more of just a feeling. And over the last several years, we've noticed more and more and more families coming to Saxapaw. In particular on Saturdays when they have the free music series that you've been hearing a lot about. I've seen more families with children at that event than I've seen anywhere else in the area or anywhere since we've been in North Carolina, as a matter of fact. And every time I speak to someone who I haven't met yet, they're always coming from some other town, which is really neat. A lot of the folks are coming from Chapel Hill and even as far as Durham on a regular basis to come on the Saturdays to be a part of the community, which is really, really great. The music venue, of course, has been attracting people from many miles around and also, like you've heard, has national recognition. The eating venues are wonderful there. The food is outstanding. It's so nice to be able to go and get good food relatively close to my home. I think that if we had known that a facility was being built in the area when we were looking for land, we would seriously have not considered moving to the area we did. I feel like Saxapaw has gone in a certain direction ever since we kind of found it and before then, and that direction is really towards, you know, families and people who are wanting to live in a rural, you know, more rural environment, but yet have a really close-knit community and be able to travel, you know, to work, you know, if necessary, further away, just so that they could come back to their quiet, peaceful community and have these, you know, events and places that they could go to eat and share their time with their families. And so I just don't see that this training facility is a really great fit for the community. I think it would really change the direction that the community is going in and has been going in for a number of years. And I do not want to see that direction change. Thanks again for your time. I really appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Lazarus. Norma Johnson, and if the following would please come forward, Tiffany Jackson, Jane Verita, Mr. Ed Shue, and Dr. Shirley Conyer, I believe it is. Norma Johnson.
Hi, my name is Norma Johnson. I live and work and own land in Saxapaw. I'm here in support of my neighbors against the location of this facility in Saxapaw. My neighbors have spoke eloquently. They've analyzed the situation very well, and I think it's very clear that this location would be very illogical, to say the least. But I do very much support our police and our firefighters and our emergency responders, and I certainly would like to offer them the best training possible. And for those who are wanting to provide that, I would very much like to see an analysis of where our people are being trained. Are they not adequately trained? And if not, what do they need and where can they get it? And I've not even seen that yet. I've seen this huge proposal for this facility. So I would like to see the other piece first. And I'm also concerned, I'm just trying to think of anything that's not been said about the possible disruption of the navigable waterway of the Haw River at this one location that would stop lots of recreational activities along the entire Haw River. So thank you very much for letting us speak.
Thank you, Ms. Johnson. Tiffany Jackson.
Thank you for letting me speak. I preface this by saying we're not sure what this is, and I do hope that what I am about to say is based on facts, with that there will be burn towers and shooting, and that's what I'm about to say is based on that information. I'm a resident of Saxapaw, and I own the Saxapaw Mercantile. I'm deeply concerned about the proposal to locate a law enforcement training facility in Saxapaw, and I ask that you find another location. Please understand that I respect and honor the work of law enforcement, especially in the county that I have chosen to make my family's home. As a business owner, I question the impact such a facility might have on the survival of my business. I collect my customers' demographics to better market my business and find that a lot of them come from Durham, Apex, and Raleigh. They drive right through Orange County to come to Alamance County because Saxapaw has become a destination because of the natural environment along the Haw River and for businesses and events that our village has to offer. I fear the attraction of Saxapaw will be negated by the noise and other environmental impacts that go along with a training facility. I'm also concerned about the impact such a facility will have on the momentum of our community. People travel a good distance to be part of this unique area in Alamance County. As a resident of Saxapaw, I would be a close neighbor to this facility. I have a young daughter that I will not raise around the noise and pollution that could come with this facility. My husband and I have lived, could have lived anywhere, but my husband chose to serve the citizens of Alamance County, and we chose to live in Saxapaw. Please help us to continue to make our life in Alamance County and choose another location for this facility. Please don't make it our neighbor. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Jackson. Jane Ferrita, is that right?
Ferrita.
Yes, that's okay. I'm not here to talk about the Saxapaw training facility. I'm here to talk about the Alamance and Guilford County line. I live in Beaver Hills Estates, and our community, we have about two-thirds of our development is in Alamance County, and one-third, less than one-third of our community is in Guilford County. And we would like you to consider making our whole development part of Alamance County. It just seems to make sense to do that. Beaver Hills Estates is a small community with one entrance in and out of the development. And that entrance is in Alamance County. In fact, the whole front of our subdivision is in Alamance County. We are we are close to the Alamance school systems, which is E.M. Holt, Southern Middle, and Southern High School. They are right down the road from us. E.M. Holt is about 11 minutes from our development, where if the children in Guilford County, the children that have to go to the Guilford Gibsonville Elementary School, that's 25 minutes away. If some of our children have to go to the Guilford County schools, we would have two county buses coming through our small development, and both of those buses would have to come through our Alamance County entrance. This would be socially, economically, and environmentally unbeneficial to our development. Our children play together, they have sleepovers, they have birthday parties together. Going to the same school just seems to make sense because they would know, the children would all know all the other children. if some of the children are going to the Guilford County schools and some are going to the Alamance County, when they get invited to their friend's house to come over for sleepovers, playtimes, or birthday parties, they do not know all the children there and sometimes will feel like an outsider. And any of you who have children or grandchildren know how important it is for the children to feel accepted by everyone. So this could be a traumatic thing for the children. All emergency facilities are closer in Alamance than in Guilford, and these emergency services have to enter our Alamance County entrance. This really concerns us because you have two counties in one development. Which emergency facility is going to come if there's a fire or if we need the EMS? And is this confusion going to cause delays in that service getting to someone, which could cause a life, or in the case of a fire, could cause greater property damage to somebody's property? So we feel that this is a very serious issue. Our doctors, our dentists, our hospitals are just up the road from our subdivision in Alamance County. We are only 3 miles from ARMC Hospital and 4 miles from Burlington.
Thank you, Ms. Carita.
My time is up?
Your time is up, but let me suggest you talk to this good-looking young man right back here with the blue shirt on. Both of you, but the one with the blue shirt on, I think he can help you on that.
Okay, well, thank you for your consideration and let me speak. I appreciate it.
What's the name of the subdivision?
It's Beaver Hills Estates.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Excuse me, I have a petition. Can I give you the petition?
Sure. Thank you, Ms. Farid. Mr. Ed Chu.
Good evening, Mr. Chairman, Commissioners. Change the subject a little bit. I don't know that it'll be a welcome change. Let's be honest about this thing. This thing with Human Relations Council started with the county attorney sending a memo out that the enemy was at the gates. The enemy was at the gates. That's basically where this started. It's turned into this political gamesmanship. Those that come here pretty well know it. They've been here. Now, a true conservative believes in that Constitution. And that Constitution says we can be idiots, we can be on the other side as long as we involve. We can do these things. And as conservative, we should have been protecting that right. That short time I worked at the DOC, first thing they done is gave me a book thicker than any I see here. And I wound up reading that thing, and I felt more like a waiter than a guard when I read the rights these convicted murderers and felons and whatnot had. The only time I actually felt like a guard was when I worked the tower with shotgun and rifle and whatnot. I thought I was a waiter. I should have had a waiter's uniform instead of the OC uniform badge. But they have those rights. These people have their rights to be whatever, if, you know, agenda they have. Now, these people don't have a very big digital footprint. I looked, and that thing that Troy should have gave you, where they gave some scholarships, is all I found they've done. Saying, you know, but that's not a harmful thing. And opposing views are not a dangerous thing. I don't know what to tell you. I just think it's unbecoming of a governing board to take what appears to be retribution for a stance that somebody took and pull these little resolutions out there. I hope you'll reconsider it, and I think we know that one's been here. We know where it all came from. In other words, it came from this guy, and I can't pronounce his name, and I'm not about to try, was somehow working with the DOJ and supported illegals or something. And this whole thing has escalated, throwed in a couple of local Tea Party members into the board to steer the mix, and came back. We know what it is. Be bigger than that. Vote it down. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Hsu. Dr. Conyers? Is that right? Conyers?
Conyard, like backyard? It's Conyard.
Conyard,
yes.
That was close.
My name is Shirley Conyard. I'm the new elected chair for the Human Relations Council. And I'm here tonight to talk about it, to let you know what we've done and how sad I am in terms of reading the paper about volunteers who take their time to come there. Okay? Now, we know that in North Carolina is more diverse in race, culture, religion, language, you name it. The county of Alamance is in the same boat. Okay? Now, what we've done, I'm not a process person or a person that gets down to business. For this year, 2014, we came up with projects because I would not take the chair unless we did that in December. Usually we don't meet in December, but we had half day to meet. This is our first project, which will be on March 6th. And I think you can see that we're in good company. It's landlord-tenant, because that's one of the priorities. Because I had gone to a meeting, and people were talking about where they live, whether they live in housing or in apartments. And the thing was, can we be neighbors? And we know that it's not only immigration, but migration. Migration brings a lot of different values, ethics, culture. So you don't have to worry about in terms of, let's just work with immigrants. People from all over are coming here. And you know, I don't have to tell you this, that companies do not like to come to a place where there's a lot of nonsense in terms of race, ethnicity, or whatever. They like quality because they bring people here and they want them to live in quality, okay, in a community. We also, our second project that we're working on, and we're working on with that, is in terms of education, because we do give out scholarships. So we had started working on this before the Director of Student Services for Alamance County retired. So now we're working with another group from Alamance County in working with six high schools. The six high schools, the reason we're working with them is to help them to establish what we call relationships, human relationships inside. And you know, the schools are not good. I check the scores every year. So there must be something in terms of a symptom there. And I understand it, because all of a sudden you're getting an influx of different values, different colors of people, different whatever.
Thank you, Ms. Conyers.
She needs to be put on the agenda. Hmm? She needs to be put on the agenda.
Yeah.
My time is up?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Then that's what I had wanted to say. And
you might want to check with the manager sometime and get on the regular agenda. This is merely public comments.
Okay.
You only have 3 minutes.
Well, I'll call and find out when the regular one is. Thank you very much.
Thank you. That concludes our public comment session. Any comments from any commissioner?
I'd like to point out an issue that Mr. Holland made in reference to the landfill. I don't, Bill, were you with us when we flew down and looked at the other one? I think I'm the only one that was on our board. We were being entertained by a regional company to sell our landfill, to become a regional landfill. And we flew down. I don't think anybody on our board really seriously was thinking about it. I was there. We were offered about $1.5 million a year for service fees if we did it, about $10 million on the barrelhead if we did it. And we flew down and looked at one. We flew over the Sharon Harris nuclear plant. Went over to Campbell College, where I went to Campbell. It was southeast. I'm not sure. What county was that? Sampson County. And we flew down and looked at it, and we went to lunch, and we came back, and it was an automatic, in my opinion, we never seriously considered, because I wasn't, with my vote, willing to sell our landfill and then have to find other space for it later for the price of one elementary school. And that's about what it's going to come to. 10 million plus $1.5 million a year, in 10 years you're looking at, what, $20 million? Well, 30 million, I think, or 25 million. That won't even pay for a school. But the bottom line is, we never seriously considered selling our landfill as a regional landfill. Yes, the talk was there, but it never was even close to a vote, in my opinion. And it was just a trip to look. That's all it was. That's as I remember.
Anything else? Let's take a brief recess.
Thank you. 5 minute break.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what happened. Now there were two.